Hi, today I want to show you this new journal that I made for myself. And for this one I made one out of an old book I used to cover, so this is hardcover. And I really wanted to try that and I think it worked out really well. Although the only thing, it's kind of slim, it's not really fat. So I kind of have to be aware with putting stuff in here that it's not getting too fat, so it won't end up like this, you know? Well, I kind of have some room, but not that much. So yeah, this is the front. Oh wait, let me show you my old one first. It's the Traveler's Notebook Midori sized. And so I use this in my handmade Traveler's Notebook as well. So this one has kind of gotten big, and so I wanted to move on to another one. I didn't use everything. Like over here, there's a couple of pages left. But I don't want it to get much bigger than this. So yeah, so that's why I decided to move on to this one. And I also just wanted to make a new journal because it's so fun to make. So I went with a kind of black and green theme. These two things I got from my pen pal, Sonia. I'll leave her link in the description because she makes really awesome journal pages. So I thought it would fit really well with my green spine. And yeah. Alright, so on the inside I used velvet. This is really soft velvet. I don't know if you can see it, but yeah. It's really nice and soft. I made a pocket. I'm planning on putting a card in here that says my name and when I started it and when I'm finishing this book, so I can see it release really quickly. So over here I already kind of decorated it with this spider web. I thought it would be really fun. Over here I'm gonna introduce myself, and I really like this one. It's like a vintage but green and black kind of vibe I was hoping for with this book. So over here there's a kind of pocket thingy, and I put some things in here that I want to use. Here's a little kind of book thingy. I made the edges black with my ink pad, so I just put the ink pad over the edges. This is tea dyed. It didn't not stain really well, but I really like it because it's pretty subtle. And I have some small pages in here as well, some black ones of course. And this is also a tea dyed one. Here I put a envelope because I thought that would be really fun. I saw people doing it, and that way the stitching is also invisible. And over here put a picture, just really simple. I don't think I will keep it in here, but just as a kind of placeholder, perhaps somewhere else, I don't know. I kept it quite just simple and not really with pockets and everything, so I left myself a lot of space to journal and also decorate. And over here you can put stuff as well. I also put some velvet over here. I just stitched it in. I have some space to journal here and it won't be really visible. And over here I have little hanger. Here is like a side pocket. Although I don't know if I'm gonna use it because I normally don't really have loose stuff hanging around. Normally I would just glue stuff down like this. And so yeah, so that's kind of my journal style. So this is kind of different, but we'll see. We'll see how this goes. I'm not sure about this one either. You can put stuff in here as well, like this. And then you can still see it, which I think is really cool. But yeah, we'll see. I just put this picture in here and I can journal over here. And I thought it would be cool to have a tab like this. And so I just put it in here. I probably will move it around and stuff. And so this is a bag. I just cut it and put the washi tape on there because it was too big for the book. Another book page. I think book pages look really cool when you have pictures on there, and also just papers where you can write. This paper, so cool. Look at that. It's so cool. I love this paper. And so I wanted to have it in the middle so you can see it on its own. So This kind of speaks for itself, I think. It's just a whole bunch of papers. And over here I put some lace. It kind of repeats itself, but yeah, I like just having space for journaling because I can write a whole lot just about like cookies or something, so I like just having a lot of space for that. Here's also a spot that I can put stuff in. I like this one as well because you can still see it, and I think that's really cool. And so here's some green paper, and this is really nice to write on, so gotta include that here. This is an envelope that I painted with stripes, so it was just white, and I wanted to glue it on here just so you have a fold out like this, but I'm not sure yet, so I'll see when I get to the page if I will glue it down or if I will use it somewhere else. It's just repeating of the same pages. And yeah, there we are at the end. This is also velvet. The edges aren't really like perfect, but it's okay, it's my book, and so it's able to not look perfect, and I'm totally fine with that. So yeah, that's the book. I'm really excited to start writing in it, to add little things. And I like that I made the edges black, because it looks kind of dark if you look at it like this. And yeah, that's totally my jam, so. So yeah, that's my junk journal. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you'll have an amazing day. And I'll see you later. Bye!